the Merc with a Mouth is back, and he's told me I've got to review him. He looks like he's got a twitchy finger. Hello and welcome to Smurred P Feature, and today we are looking at the Uncanny X-Force Deadpool, which is a Comic-Con exclusive. To be fair, I'm not really sure what Comic-Con exclusive it was, but it popped up in the one over here in London, and it may have come from San Diego, I don't know. And anyway, Comics and Cocktails supplied me with this because they are awesome and they always find a way to get us the figures that are elusive, so to speak. So thank you, Comics and Cocktails. I probably don't say that enough, because without you my life would be hell and I'd be trolling on Evil Bay, which nobody wants. So with this figure, I actually didn't snap him up straight away. I actually sat on the fence for quite a while thinking, why do I need this figure when I've already got a classic Deadpool figure? And we'll get into it when I guess I'm showing it off, but one of the things that I liked was, I guess this, I saw a couple of videos and it was kind of like the blue kind of tinge on it that I thought was, wow, that's pretty darn impressive. I really actually do like the look of this Deadpool, maybe more than the Deadpool that I've got, so hence why I've got it. So the top is like that. So the box, the outer box is really nice. It reminds me of when we had the Marvel Universe line. We got those exclusive, that Old Man Logan exclusive and that Archangel exclusive, and they came in the white box outside of it. And it just, the white box really complements it. I mean, it makes it really nice. And if you're a mint in box collector, which I'm not really for Marvel Legends, I was for Marvel Universe, it just adds value to it. And, you know, maybe you think about getting two of these. Not that I'm trying to get you to buy two, but if you get two, you know, you can keep one nicely in a box for a later date, or maybe it's an investment. Some of us invest by buying these things, some of us don't. I will never sell my X-Men collection ever, so unless I feel that there's a better figure out there to fit that collection, that's the only time that I will feel like I would upgrade, I guess is the word. So let's get it out. And if you can hear Frozen in the background, that's my youngest downstairs. Listening to that, it's not part of the video. It's not the background music to this video. So if you capture a glimpse of it, let it go, so to speak. So I've got to say that I love the packaging. This packaging for this figure and the retro line were absolutely stunning anyway for the X-Men. And I almost feel like I haven't brought a second set, but it's so tempting when it looks so beautiful. And it almost makes me want to be a mint and card collection just for that part of this. So it's really nice. So one thing I did notice, 14 plus, never acknowledged it in the past, but never noticed it. But maybe that's because they've considered this figure comes with weapons, etc. So I don't know any 14-year-olds that are, unless there are real Marvel fans, would be, I guess, playing with toys. Don't get me wrong, I played with toys till, well, went to adulthood, and, well, I still collect them. I don't play with them, though. I just set them up and try and make them look cool. And even I can't do that sometimes, so, you know. Enough about me anyway. So the figure, so some of the people brought this figure because he comes with some extra weapons, whereas the 2016 version was very light. He came with his katanas, but he was very light on that aspect. So he got the big gun, the little handgun, and the two color mini machine guns. He hasn't got that many hands, so I'm not sure what you're going to do with it. I do like how the back is here and how he's covering up the other retro lines in the X-Men. It's pretty cool. It's got this thing that you would expect from Deadpool, a little menage where he's yapping away, etc. It's got a thing which is reminds me of the 1992 cards on the back about Deadpool. So yeah, so they've given this figure a lot of thought, a lot of time, and a lot of investment, I would say. And it's very, very nice. So in the background, in case you notice, I've got my Deadpool and X-Force Omnibus, because they did this because Deadpool was kind of first showed up in X-Force, and he was a big thorn in his sides. But I haven't read it all yet. Those who watch me know that I haven't read any of the X-Force, because I'm still trying to finish New Mutants. And when I finish that, I'm going to jump straight into that. And I have read some of the earlier issues of Deadpool and some of his stuff that did cross over with X-Force. So I have read some of it, not all of it. So I reserve judgment. I think for me, I think I found his early stuff, other than Daniel Way, he was a better character, and he's become, like Wolverine, overused. And that's kind of disappointing. I hated how they overused Wolverine. It almost made me hate the character, almost. So I don't really read Deadpool now. I mean, you know, I've got his Cable, the Cable and Deadpool Omnibus, but I don't go out of my way to read Deadpool unless he's in something like Uncanny Avengers, where, you know, I did read him, and I enjoyed his friendship with Rogue, actually. That was very interesting. So let's get him out anyway. Let's look at this figure. I'm just yapping away here. So just before I start talking about the figure and showing you the figure, I just want to show you this picture where you kind of get the feel that this is very black, but it's got the kind of blue tinges that go with it. So hence why I feel that this figure is the better figure. Don't get me wrong, the other Deadpool works as Deadpool later, where he, well, it's usually black, the eyes and the arms, etc. But I just thought I'd show you this picture quickly before I start showing you the figure and why I think this is the superior figure, I guess, in my mind. Okay, so I'm hoping you're going to be able to see what I mean in terms of the color on this figure. So, and obviously I'll compare it to the other Deadpool. So, really, really a damn good paint job on this figure. Absolutely glorious. And I think that's what makes, mainly it's the paint work that makes this figure, you know, other than that, it's just a Deadpool figure that we've had before. But it is, and they've added that bit on as well. But it is ultimately the color that seems to really make this Deadpool the better Deadpool. Okay, so he comes with two katanas that he got from the last figure. I can't remember if he came with just a gun. I'd have to look that up. But either that, people felt that he lacked accessories. But I wouldn't buy this figure for the accessories. I'd buy him for the color upgrade. In terms of other guns, he comes with... My camera focuses. Focus. Comes with this lovely machine guns. And you're not going to focus again, are you? Oh, wait a minute. There we go. There we go. There they are together. Very nice. And he comes with the bigger gun, which we've probably seen this gun before as well. And it just comes with some really nice paint apps in certain areas. There are other bits that they could have done with this figure, like, but you know what? I'm not going to complain. I got this figure for a decent price. So, and I think, you know, not many people, I think some people may have paid over the odds for this figure. But I certainly haven't, so I'm not going to gripe about a certain guns, etc. I say the one thing that I'm good about Deadpool is I never got the X-Force Deadpool that came from the San Diego, because the one that we got after that was not as impressive in terms of the weapons. You never got the weapons that went with it, so that's disappointing. One other thing that I'd say is it would have been nice to get just a Wade head to go with this, or a half unmasked head. I think that would have been kind of cool to go with this figure, I guess. But, you know, once again, not going to gripe. Not a stupidly expensive figure. Here he is with the katanas, which we've seen before. Only just with slight blue to blend in. If my thing will focus. Oh, you don't want to focus. say hello to my little friends. I feel like he holds these really nicely, and you can get his arm into a nice little pose if he was just, you know, running around the room, going crazy with these hand machine guns, which is something you could imagine him doing. He'd probably do some better things with his legs than I've done. I don't have a stand. I really do need to invest in some stands at some point to do better things with these figures when I'm showing them off. But they're a nicety, nice thing. I'm not so bothered about them, to be fair. But it is a nice addition, a nice thing for Hasbro to give us, because some of us like doing lots of things with guns. With Deadpool, I'm probably going to do stuff with his swords, to be fair. But that's just me. But you can always use the guns for something else as well. And here he is with the nice shiny gun, the red long gun. I don't know what make of gun this is. I don't like guns, to be fair. But that's just me. But I like how he holds it. It actually fits really nicely with him, I feel. So very nice addition with him. And here he is with the Deadpool we got back in 2016 as part of the Juggernaut wave, if I'm correct. So you can see the difference. So you can see that they've added a second one on there because that just looks bizarre. And he maybe wore two of them when he did it. You can see the paint difference. So the blue is pretty much replacing the black all the way through. Looks very nice. I think if they had done this black, it would have just worked as well. And then just looking at the two swords, you can see if it focuses. Come on. You can see that they've just changed the colors to a slightly blue, and they got black sleeves, whereas these have the kind of blue ones as well. So very subtle, simple changes that upgrade this figure. And they've given you a load of extra guns. So what more could you want as a fan, you know, if you want to upgrade? Or even if you miss this Deadpool, you know, rather than pay. We've had quite a few Deadpools over the last few years. And they seem to have given us focus on that. Whereas before, it would have been super hard to get a Deadpool from the 2013 ones. But they've certainly made up for that. And those who have missed out have had the opportunity to get nice new shiny ones. So, but I like this one just as much as this one, because this one you can still use as well as this one, but I'm probably just going to keep them both. There we go. And here he is with the rest of the X-Force team. Now, from what I remember, Deadpool just used to be a hindrance to them throughout the whole thing. Even though him and Cable were kind of like weird best friends, it's kind of odd. And I love Deadpool and Cable's relationship anyway, but once again, I've not read it, so I can't really comment too much on it, but I suspect Deadpool was a great character to mess with X-Force, should we say. So I'm looking forward to more X-Force figures as well next year in completing that squad, especially Seer and Sunspot. We need one of those. We also need a normal Cannonball, for goodness sake, with real legs. So, but for now, I'm quite content with this Deadpool joining this X-Force mix as well. So for me, this is a great figure and a great addition to any collection. I would buy him again. Not going to. Like, comment, subscribe, follow my page on Facebook, SmurfP. Follow me on Twitter at SmurfP. No idea what I'm doing, but I'm there. And as always, embrace the geekiness. Take care. Goodbye.